For over a century, futurists have envisioned trains screaming across the landscape faster than the speed of sound. What if you could zip between cities at a pace rivaling jets? As implausible as it seems, China stands at the cusp of debuting ultra-high-velocity rail that can traverse hundreds of miles in the time it takes to watch a movie. Powered by exotic technology like magnetic levitation and vacuum-sealed tunnels, these hyperloops set their sights past even the fastest high-speed trains cruising today. Will frictionless carriages one day shoot human cargo across the country at 620 miles per hour, allowing you to grab lunch in Shanghai and finish sightseeing in Beijing? China is betting billions that the answer is yes. But formidable challenges remain. As sci-fi transforms into reality, can engineering truly deliver with safety, efficiency, and affordability scaled to the extreme? The race is on to find out. China recently achieved a groundbreaking transportation milestone when a prototype of its next-generation high-speed Maglev train hit speeds over 600 km per hour, 370 miles per hour, during April 2023 testing. This test run served an important purpose beyond showcasing raw power. Engineers leveraged the demo to evaluate critical safety factors like stability, aerodynamics, sensors, and control systems when operating at such blistering pace. So far, the results look promising. Buoyed by this successful test, China is now building an even more ambitious 20-kilometer test track for pushing maglev trains past 1,000 km per hour, 620 miles per hour, an extreme speed that would slash travel time between the cities of Shanghai and Hangzhou to a mere 9 minutes, down from well over an hour. China's rapid progress signals its seriousness about advancing maglev technology and pioneering new transportation capabilities previously confined to the realm of science fiction. More refinement is still needed, but the latest series of testing breakthroughs underscores China's leading position in ushering ultra-high-speed rail into reality. Clearly, this stretches far beyond existing high-speed rail as we know it. To grasp how such extreme velocity is achievable, we should explore the engineering magic propelling these vehicles. China's hyper-high-speed train, as it's called, combines two game-changing innovations. First is magnetic levitation, or maglev. Magnetic levitation, or maglev, enables the train to float just inches above the guideway as it glides along. Electromagnets on the train interact with electric currents in the track, allowing the train to levitate through electromagnetic suspension. Without friction from wheels or axles slowing it down, the train can accelerate unimpeded to unprecedented speeds, almost as if it's flying at high velocities. Second, the enclosed low-pressure tube maintains a near vacuum, eliminating drag so the train slices through air resistance. It's frictionless travel meeting aerodynamic minimalism, a transportation perfect storm enabling unprecedented pace. Engineers plan initial routes like Shanghai to Hangzhou because enormous population density makes them prime early adopters. China envisions a national network measured first in thousands of kilometers, eventually expanding to tens of thousands. Optimists enthuse how it could thoroughly reshape mobility, logistics, even urban planning. But possibilities also provoke tough questions. A crucial question surrounding hyper-high-speed rail is whether safety can truly be guaranteed at unprecedented velocities over 600 miles per hour, where devastating kinetic energy intensification poses grave risks. Consider even a 60 miles per hour car collision can mangle vehicles beyond recognition. The impact forces scale exponentially higher at 7 to 10 times that speed. To address this, Chinese engineers have incorporated four fail-safe mechanisms for crash protection. First, elevating the guideway prevents collisions with other traffic altogether. Second, emergency mechanical brakes housed in the undercarriage activate during incidents to rapidly halt the pod. Third, the same linear induction motors that accelerate the train can also decelerate it in case of emergency. Finally, reinforced pneumatic shock absorber cylinders are built into the frame to absorb monstrous impact forces should a severe crash still occur somehow. Redundancies across these systems provide backup protection. However, with such velocities in play, near 100% reliability in preventing accidents becomes mandatory, because even extraordinarily minute risks yield catastrophic outcomes when hugely intensified by speed. Thus, despite the safeguards, any deviations from flawless performance likely introduce intolerable hazards. This technology therefore permits virtually no margin of error across thousands of high-risk operational components. Additional key challenges facing hyper-high-speed rail developers are noise and energy efficiency. Noise pollution poses major concerns, as the train's unprecedented speeds risk generating thunderous sonic booms that disturb heavily populated urban areas. Engineers have attempted noise reduction by encasing tubes in sound insulation membranes and installing special low-noise fans. However, it remains unclear if decibel levels can stay within socially tolerable thresholds as speeds amplify exponentially. Extensive acoustic data collection from upcoming real-world testing will determine if noise can be contained to acceptable levels. Energy use also raises open questions. Early estimates indicate hyper-high-speed rail could require over 50% more electricity per passenger kilometer than commercial aviation, an extremely energy-intensive form of transportation. Achieving competitive power consumption will be crucial for feasibility. That's why engineers are focused intently on maximizing regenerative braking systems, which capture huge amounts of kinetic energy dissipated as heat during deceleration. Reusing this recycled electricity can significantly boost energy efficiency. Further areas like solar power integration and lower resistance designs offer more paths to optimize energy expenditure. But until large-scale operation commences, uncertainty persists around the true efficiency profile. And of course, sheer cost looms as the sine qua non, the essential condition determining if this remains an elusive pipe dream or realistic breakthrough innovation. By now, you've likely grasped why realizing such blistering pace carries intricacies. Yet China seems uniquely equipped to attempt this moonshot, thanks to three vital constituents. First is strong central government endorsement and financing. Make no mistake, political commitment primed the pump. Beijing designated hyper-high-speed rail a key technology domain under its Made in China 2025 agenda. That triggered billions in investment from state-owned railway operator CRRC. Second, rapidly advancing Chinese R&D nourishes breakneck innovation. CRRC leads globally on high-speed rail, giving its engineers invaluable expertise. Academic and defense research partners like Southwest Jiaotong University and the People's Liberation Army Rocket Force bolster capabilities. And third, concentrated manufacturing clusters close collaboration gaps between institutions, transforming ideas into deliverables. Leveraging these synergies, China constructs testbeds, setting world records for sheer speed. Looking ahead, China's first hyper-high-speed rail carrying passengers is expected to debut between Shanghai and Hangzhou by around 2025, with an aim to connect the cities in under 10 minutes. These initial routes will provide real-world testing grounds to evaluate and optimize the systems before expansion. Construction costs per kilometer are projected to start extremely high, likely surpassing $100 million as the technology's complexity is refined. However, expenses could gradually decrease over time as engineers standardize techniques and scale up cost-effective solutions based on data and experience gained from the pioneering routes. The Shanghai to Hangzhou line represents the first step toward more ambitious, wider-reaching applications. Safety ultimately determines mainstream adoption. If negligible incidents surface across tens of thousands of early journeys, expect bolder geographic reach. Perhaps one day passengers could flit between Beijing and Guangzhou at aircraft velocities, traversing nearly 1,500 miles in around 2 hours. Of course, unforeseen obstacles may slow momentum, but with success, China's hyper-high-speed train could trigger profound second-order effects. Just look at how bullet trains realigned economic geography and travel patterns across China today. The nation doubling down on magnitude faster trains reveals ambitions aimed well into the future. All eyes turn east as the Middle Kingdom leads a mobility revolution.